All right, let's go start a new sheet metal component here. So the right-click menus are still here. These are still customizable if you would like. So we'll come in here and create us a rectangle very quickly. And we'll say this one is 6x8. Finish our sketch. And as we apply a face, now we have our face property panel. So again, this can be docked right here. So if I don't want to see it on screen, or if I want to keep it off screen, we can dock it there, can dock it to the other side, or we can leave it floating right here as well. And so are we flipping the direction? Are we centerline about the direction? What rule are we going to use? Listed right here. So we can pull this in, pull this out. We want to give it a specific body name for the first one. So different options here we've got. If you don't want to see that, you can just collapse that. But we'll select OK here. So now as we start working with the cut and the face commands, we've got these different property panels now that are added in here. And so if we come over and say, let's add a flange here and a flange here. And we'll just grab our angle here and rotate this around the 45. We can grab these, the manipulators here, and address these. And then here we've got all of the different information here that we used to have in the old dialog box. Now we've got it all right here in one screen right in front of us. And so again, if we're not worried about the bin reliefs, bin properties, we can collapse that so we can see more. If we want to see, all right, what type of gap size, we want to go look at the list of parameters that are available. We can pull those from there. If we want to type it in, do we want to make this a round corner? We want to trim to bend it. Want to make it a tear, how we're going to make it. So we've got all those options available right here inside the dialog window, right here in our property panel. Now, the property panel, some users love it. Some users can't get used to not having the old dialog boxes. They do have some merit there. If we were adding just a new sketch here, and say we were going to just bring up an extrusion and we're working right here. When we're working in certain commands like that, you can toggle back and forth between the sketch and the extrusion without ever leaving the dialog box. So if we have any dimensions on this, we can go back and edit those while we're in this dialog here. So these little breadcrumbs that the property panels leave, those are available there for a reason. And that is to help us get back and forth through there between the commands without having to edit a command and go back and edit the feature and go back and edit the sketch and finish it and go back and edit the feature. We can just go back and forth between those two there.